Hi, this is Attorney Haji Hidlao, and welcome to my channel, Demeter Pharma. Now guys, if you like my videos and my discussions, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and share our videos. Thank you and God bless.
Hi, this is Attorney Haji, and welcome to Demeter Pharma. Guys, our episode for today is all about Criminal Law, Book 1, under the Revised Penal Code. So, here we go. Our topic is Article 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, which is about consummated, frustrated, attempted felonies, conspiracy, grave, less grave, and slight felonies. So, let's start. Bago ang lahat, kumusta pala sa mga estudyante ko sa Pasay City College? And sana ay nag-aaral kayo mabuti. Okay, so, para saan itong episode na to? Okay, Article 6 is all about consummated, frustrated, and attempted felonies. Take note guys that consummated, frustrated, and attempted felonies are all punishable. So, isa-isahin natin. A felony is consummated when all elements necessary for its execution and accomplishment are present. Next, it is frustrated when the offender performs all the acts of execution which would produce the felony as a consequence, but which nevertheless do not produce it by reason of causes independent of the will of the perpetrator. Okay? So, if you memorize specifically Article 6, may 5 points na kayo. Okay? So, next. And lastly, the last paragraph, which is also equally important, is that there is an attempt when the offender commences the commission of a felony directly by overt acts and does not perform all the acts of execution which should produce the felony by reason of some cause or accident other than his own spontaneous desistance. Okay, so we discuss first consummated felonies. Okay. So, paano ba natin siya iintindihin? Take note guys that in the development of a crime, meron tayong tinatawag na internal acts and external acts. Okay? Pag ang action, you are impelled, you are compelled to commit a crime, is an internal act which refers to intent and plans, usually is not punishable. Okay? However, if the act becomes external, so preparatory acts which are already considered a crime and acts of execution which are acts directly connected to the crime, these actions are already punishable. Okay? So, as a rule, mere intention to commit a crime is not punishable for as long as there is no physical form of the internal act, the same is outside of the inquiry of criminal law. Okay guys, tandaan nyo yan. Pwedeng lumabas yan sa exam. Okay. So, here, we need to differentiate the stages of the commission of a crime. In the attempted stage, the overt acts of execution did not yet start. However, in the frustrated stage, all the acts of execution are already present. In consummated, lahat na ng acts of execution nagawa na. And the result sought is already achieved. So, guys, isa-isahin natin yung pag anong tawag niyan? Pag-explain ng stages of the commission of a crime, okay? So note that in the three stages in the commission of the crime, lahat 'yan by means of dolo. Hindi ito yung felonies committed by culpa or negligence. So magkaiba guys yung elements of negligence as another means to commit felony. Okay? So kanina may nabanggit sa attempted stage na desistance on the part of the offender negates criminal liability in the attempted stage. Okay? So take note that in the attempted stage, desistance is on true only in the attempted stage of the felony. So pag nag-desist ang actor ay ang or ang suspect before he commits any of the acts of execution, wala siyang criminal liability. Okay? So take note that the spontaneous desistance of the offender negates only the attempted stage but not necessarily all criminal liability. As long as, guys, na wala siyang participation sa any other actions except if he is the mastermind. So, yon. May liability pa rin pag siya yung mastermind. Okay? So, there are three factors in that is being considered when whether the crime is considered as frustrated, consummated, or attempted. These are the manner of committing the crime, the elements of the crime, and nature of the crime itself. Okay? So, isa-isahin natin yan. Ah. Now, as to the matter of the manner of committing the crime, let us take for example the crime of bribery. Can the crime, and here's the question, can the crime of frustrated bribery be committed? The answer is no. Why? Because bribery is the crime of the receiver and not the giver. The crime of the giver is corruption of public officers, while bribery is the crime of the public officer who, in consideration of an act having to do with his official functions, would receive something or accept any promise or present in consideration thereof. Okay? Now, in bribery, guys, once na tumanggap ang isang public official ng regalo kapalit ng kanyang pabor, ay automatically, that is, consummated. Consummated na ang the crime of bribery. Ang corruption of public officers naman is the act of giving already is considered as corruption of public officers kahit hindi niya tinanggap yung suhol. Okay? So, clear yan, ha? Also, in the crime of theft and estafa, guys, sa crime of theft, once you have appropriated in the crime of theft, once you took possession of something without the consent of the owner, tapos itinakas mo, that is consummated theft. In estafa, what do you need in estafa? In estafa, guys, the possession of the property is transferred to you legally. However, for it to be considered as estafa, you need to misappropriate it and damage is proven dun sa may sa owner ng thing or ng pera. So, here in the manner of committing the crime, dun mo makikita kung frustrated ba siya, consummated ba siya, or attempt in an attempted stage. Okay? Clear yan, guys, ha? Now, next is the elements of the crime. Okay. In the elements of the crime, in the case of estafa and theft, damage or intent to cause damage is necessary for you to be convicted of consummated estafa. While in the crime of theft, damage is not an element. Because in the crime of theft, the intent to gain is presumed. Okay? Intent to gain is presumed. So, malinaw yan, ha, na in case you are faced with a problem na in terms of estafa and theft, estafa and theft, in estafa, you need to prove the element of damage. While in theft, intent to gain is presumed upon the taking of the property. Okay? So, yun. Next, lastly, is the nature of the crime itself. Okay. Take for example the following crimes. Parricide, homicide, and murder. Now, guys, take note that in those crimes, it is necessary that the victim be mortally wounded para ma-consider siya in a frustrated stage. Syempre, pag nabatay yung victim, automatically siya consummated. Whether it's parricide, homicide, or murder. However, for it to be frustrated, kailangan is mortally wounded or the wound must cause death. Okay? In an attempted stage naman, if it's not mortal, if it's not a mortal wound, then it's only an attempted stage. Okay? So, sa isang suntukan, that's this. Sa isang suntukan, once na nasaksak ka, tapos yung nasaksak sa'yo ay tagiliran lang naman, would you file a case? Can the fiscal charge the suspect attempted murder or frustrated murder? Sa tagiliran ka, sa shoulder or sa tagiliran ka, nasaksak. Guys, the wound is not, what's this? It's not critical. You will live. Or sabihin natin, nagasgasan ka lang. And you file for attempted murder, frustrated murder, then, hindi. Okay? So, yun. So, that is the criteria in how to decide whether the crime is frustrated, consummated, or attempted. Now, we go to Article 7. When is light felonies punishable? So, guys, ano ba yung mga light felonies? Okay? So, these light felonies, slight physical injuries, malicious mischief, ano pa ba? All slights, okay? They are only punishable when they have been consummated wala siyang attempted or frustrated stage. Okay? Except if the crime is against persons or property. Take note of the crime against persons or property. We will discuss this further as we go along. Okay? Next. Conspiracy. Okay. Ito yung medyo mabigat na topic. Okay. Conspiracy and proposal to commit a felony. Take note of the word conspiracy. As defined under Article 8, conspiracy exists when two or more persons come to an agreement concerning the commission of a felony and decide to commit it. There is proposal when the person who has decided to commit a felony proposes its execution to some other person or persons. Now, yung question dito sa examination, ganito yung paka-frame. When is conspiracy considered as a crime and when is it not? Okay? When it is not. Conspiracy is considered as a crime directly when in cases of conspiracy to commit treason, rebellion, or insurrection, sedition, coup d'etat, and monopolies, combination and restraint of trade. Pero ang importante dito, guys, is conspiracy and treason, rebellion, or insurrection, sedition, coup d'etat. So, kahit wala ka sa pag-commit ng treason, once the evidence has been found that you are part of the group who wants to commit treason, rebellion, insurrection, sedition, and coup d'etat, you are liable for those crimes. However, in ordinary crimes, kailangan, conspiracy to commit a crime is not to be confused with conspiracy as a means to committing a crime. Okay? When there is an agreement to commit a crime, agreement pa lang yun, and no crime has yet been committed, then it's not yet punishable, except in treason, rebellion, or sedition. So, when conspiracy is considered as a means of committing the crime, it should be separately established and there must be evidence to show that the actor, the conspirator, is in direct participation or participated one way or another in committing a crime. Okay? So, first, how is conspiracy committed? Two ways. First, there must be an agreement, whether written or oral. So, ito madali ito. Agreement, written, or oral. May ebidensya tayo dyan. Now, in number two, ano ba yung number two? Number two, the participants acted in concert or simultaneously, which is indicative of a meeting of the mind towards a common criminal goal or criminal objective. Okay? So, ang importante dito is ito, synchronized, coordinated manner. So, ito yung tinatawag na implied agreement in conspiracy or implied conspiracy. Okay? But, guys, take note, kahit dito sa implied conspiracy, kailangan there must be sufficient evidence for the prosecutor to show to the prosecution team to show it that there is really conspiracy on the part of the accused. Guys, conspiracy meaning there are two or more perpetrators. Okay? So, yun nga, conspiracy as a crime, treason, rebellion, insurrection, or sedition, coup d'etat, and conspiracy as a manner of incurring criminal liability. Now, when conspiracy itself is a crime, no overt act is necessary to bring about the criminal liability. The mere conspiracy is the crime itself. Okay? So, malinis yun ah. Yung conspiracy doon is you need to establish that the conspirator is part of the group. Okay? So, sa treason, rebellion, sedition, pudeta lang yun. So, when the conspiracy is only a base of incurring criminal liability, there must be an overt act done before the co-conspirators become criminally liable. Okay? Let us take, for example, the crime of robbery or snatching. Kadalasan sa Manila or any other urban city, meron dyan apat na operatiba ang mga magnanakaw. Ang isa dyan, ang participation niyan ay maging lookout. Yung isa, yung mag-distract ng attention ng nanakawan, yung runner, kung apat na sa isang four-man team, ha, isang lookout, isang runner, isang distractor, at isang drop point kung saan siya nagtatago ng ninakaw. Okay? Sa apat sa four-man team na yan, they are all liable for robbery. So, for the prosecution to nail those suspects, there must be testimony or evidence to show that those four acted in concert. Otherwise, sir, hindi po ako lookout, tambay lang po ako doon. Okay? Kailangan merong testimony sa lahat to show that there is conspiracy. Okay? So as a general rule, if there has been conspiracy to commit a crime in particular place, anyone who did not appear shall be presumed to have desisted. So, the exception to this, if such person who did not appear was the mastermind, as mentioned a while ago. Okay? Yung mastermind, sa mga pagnanakaw, hindi naman yan nakikita sa kung saan sila sa lugar na nag-ooperate. Usually, nasa hideout sila. Okay? So, yun na. So, take note, in establishing conspiracy as a manner of incurring criminal liability, the parts of the conspirators must be clearly established in the affidavits and at the information. Okay? Article 9. Grave felonies are those to which the law attaches the capital punishment of what? Those that are afflictive. Less grave, the penalty is correctional. Okay? In light felonies, arresto mayor or a fine not exceeding 200 pesos. Okay. Madali lang to, guys. Ang capital punishment, death penalty, and 6 years and 1 day to reclusion perpetua, these are considered as grave felonies. Felonies that carries with it the imprisonment of 6 years and 1 day to reclusion perpetua. Saan ang jurisdiction nito? You will hear the jurisdiction ng mga crimes na ito sa regional trial court. Okay? How about less grave? Less grave is 1 month and 1 day to 6 years. And light is arresto menor ang imprisonment. sa last grave, guys, ang anong tawag niya? Ang jurisdiction ng court ay nasa municipal trial court only. Okay? So, pag grave ang penalty, meaning lampas siya ng 6 years or 6 years and 1 day to reclusion perpetua. So, less grave and light is within the jurisdiction of the municipal trial court. Take note of this, guys. Ha? Okay? So, that's it. And hopefully, you've enjoyed the topic for today. And if you like my videos and my discussion, please don't forget to subscribe and like my channel. Thank you. And once again, this is Attorney Haji Hidlao from Demeter Pharma.